Remember this. Man can create nothing which he does not first conceive in the form of an impulse of thought. Man's thought impulses begin immediately to translate themselves into their physical equivalent, whether those thoughts are voluntary or involuntary. Keep fear out of your mind by concentrating on the mental picture of your goal, your greatest desire. Now, I want to mention that Think and Grow Rich as a book carries more endorsements by great men who knew of its truth than any other book of its kind ever written. I'll touch on only a few. All of these great men actually endorsed Napoleon Hill's principles. Former President of the United States William Howard Taft, F.W. Woolworth wrote that he had built his great chain of stores by applying many of these principles. Robert Dollar, who built the great Dollar steamship line, wrote, "If I had had this philosophy 50 years ago, I suppose I could have accomplished all that I've done in less than half the time. I sincerely hope the world will discover and reward you." Samuel Gompers wrote that the mastery of these principles is the equivalent of an insurance policy against failure. President Woodrow Wilson, John Wanamaker, the merchant prince, wrote, "I know that your fundamentals are sound because I've been applying them in my business for more than 30 years. George Eastman, the world's largest maker of cameras, Thomas Edison, Luther Burbank, Theodore Roosevelt, E.M. Statler, John D. Rockefeller. I think you know that the endorsements of these great men could not have been bought with all the money in the world. What we have been talking about here can change your life, can bring you anything and everything worthwhile you want in life for yourself and your family. Cut yourself away from the average, from the mediocre, and chart your course on the dream in your heart. These 13 principles will never let you down, as long as you use them. And now, it is with great pleasure that I give you the author himself, Napoleon Hill."
Thank you, Earl Nightingale. The message which you, who are listening, have just heard has brought you within three short steps of the supreme secret of success. The same secret which has brought happiness, peace of mind, and financial success to countless thousands of people who have read Think and Grow Rich. The same secret which has made master salesmen out of ordinary order takers. And the same secret which has brought friendship, love, and marriage to men and women who have come under the spell of the 13 principles which Earl Nightingale has just described. You desire the better things of life, or you wouldn't be listening to this record. Come with me then, and I will help you chart your course so you may acquire whatever it is that you desire most in life by following these instructions. 1. Condition your own subconscious mind to work for you while you sleep as well as when you are awake. You can do this by playing this record to yourself every night just before you retire. Then, before you go to sleep, after hearing the record, write out a clear statement of what you wish to accomplish the following day, and request your subconscious mind to work during the night and provide you with the plan you will need to achieve your purpose. 2. Form a personal mastermind group of two or more people who are closely associated with you. They can be members of your family, your business, or your professional associates, or people who work where you are employed, and play this record in their presence at least once a week. After you have done this, engage in a friendly roundtable discussion of the 13 success principles and request each person in the group to participate and to look for inspirational ideas which may help him or her to become more successful. 3. Beginning now, follow the habit of rendering more service and better service than that which is expected of you, and do it in a pleasing, positive mental attitude. This will make friends for you, it will increase the value of your services, and it will attract opportunities by which you may get from life whatever it is that you most desire. Follow these instructions to the letter, and you will surely see the day when you can express a prayer of gratitude for having had the privilege of hearing and acting on the message which Earl Nightingale has given you through this record. And now, may I reach out across the space and the time which separate us and offer you a hand of friendship and a sincere prayer that you will be blessed with a richer and a fuller life because of this message. Your big opportunity may be right where you are now. Follow these instructions faithfully, and it will reveal itself to you. This is Napoleon Hill saying, don't search for opportunity in the distance, but recognize it and embrace it right where you are.